Hi you all. Welcome to the third video in the series of videos that I'm making about South Africa Critical Skills Visa. This is the third step in the steps required for applying for South Africa Critical Skills Visa. This is the third step, which is professional body membership. Let's see what professional body membership is all about. Professional bodies are the organization that give a person an option to register with them, where they evaluate your school skills based on your past qualification, your work experience, your references, and then they provide you with certificate, a registration certificate with them that vouches your skill in a particular category in a field. So basically, in very simple terms, what that means is that you register with a professional body based on a professional body in your skill category. For example, for computer science, there are at least two professional bodies, which is IIT PSA and then ICITP. So based on your skill, you register with the professional body, you provide them with your documents, like anything that vouches your skill, your critical skill that you're applying for. So basically your past work experiences, your work references, your CV, your qualification, all that. You pay a fee to them and then they evaluate your skills and then they provide you with a certificate with a critical skill letter, which you use for your critical skills visa application. This is the third step in the four-step process for critical skills visa. I mentioned this in my first video. If you haven't checked out my first video, please make sure to go and check that out. The link is in the description. I'm also attaching the list of professional bodies that are recognized right now. I got this list from the DHA website. The link is in the description. Let's see how to register with a professional body. Before registering with the professional body, what you need to do is you need to contact them. So basically they evaluate your skill and then give you a membership category and code for that membership. What you need to do is, after getting that code, you need to make a payment. You can pay through your card. Make sure to keep the proof of payment, because you need that as a proof when you submit your document. Like, what all documents you need depends on the organization that you are registering with. I registered with an organization that evaluates computer science skills, so that I will list down all the documents that I submitted, but it can vary depending on the organization. Document that I needed was SAQUA certificate, a graduation certificate, my transcript, high school mark sheet and certificate, your passport copy, your offer letter if you have a job already in South Africa, a reference letter from your current or previous employer, current employer's confirmation letter. If for some reason you can't get that, you can also send your offer letter. On top of this, as I mentioned, you also need proof of payment. You submit all these documents, they need to be certified. And I send them over email. I didn't send the actual hard copy, but make sure to confirm this with your organization. After submitting these documents, let's see how long does it take to get the response. For my case, it took 22 days, but it can vary depending on your organization. My recommendation is that make sure to be in contact with them. Let's say you are in a hurry, make sure to let them know. It's possible that they may process your application faster. After you have submitted your application, all your documents, what do you get back in return? Professional bodies mail you the hard copy of your certificate and your critical skills letter. This is the tricky part. This is where the confusion comes from. A lot of professional organizations don't provide you with critical skills letters. And if you go to DHA website, at least at the time of making this video, you'll see that both the things are required: registration with professional body and critical skills letter. Actually, the confusion comes from Directive 22. Directive 22 says that a registration with professional body is enough to prove that you have the skill, you have the critical skill. But since this directive only came in 2014, there is still no general consensus about it. There is still some misunderstanding, and not everyone knows about it. So my recommendation is to make sure that you get your critical skills letter and your membership registration certificate. But for some reason, let's say your professional organization doesn't provide it, or for some reason, if you don't have the critical skill letter, make sure to attach Directive 22 with your application. That will help you a lot. I hope this video was helpful and it gave you some clarity about the process. Please make sure to like this video and also add comment, give me your feedback. Also, please make sure to subscribe to my channel. Since this channel is still new, your subscription gives me instant feedback that what I'm doing is helping you, and that encourages me to keep making new videos. I'm gonna leave you all with some pictures, some shots that I took recently. Until next time.